Ashok Singhgupta sir to join. Yes, I can see him. Ashok sir, I have accepted yours, so you can join me. Good evening, Ashok sir.
Good evening. One second, my video, I can't see video.
You can't see video.
Actually, I can't see myself.
Oh.
Can you see me?
Yes, I can see you.
Oh, that's okay. Is it okay that I am in a very informal situation? Lockdown situation.
No problem, sir. No problem. So how are you, sir? How's quarantine going on?
I'm fine. Good evening, everybody. I'm fine. So how is life?
Life is boring currently.
Oh my God. It is so, not that boring for me. It is boring, but since I'm confined in a campus,
yeah,
which is having about 4 acres of forest. So yeah. My time is going on very well without much of a trouble.
Yeah. So we'll start this session. Before starting the session, let me give a small introduction about you to the viewers. So Ashok Singhgupta sir is a PG, postgraduate teacher in computer science at Kendra Vidyalaya in Bangalore. And Ashok sir is a nature lover and has been documenting butterflies, especially the life cycle of a lot of butterflies in Western Ghats for closely 10 years now, if I'm right. And he has also a small butterfly club in the school where he's working. And he's one of the founding members of BBC, the Bangalore Butterfly Club. So we'll start with the question and answer session, the same question which I've been asking all the people who have joined me earlier from morning. So the first question is, how did you start butterflying? How did it all start?
I arrived in Bangalore. Before arriving to Bangalore, I was posted at a place in central India, very close to Kanha National Park called Jabalpur. Everybody knows Jabalpur. Yeah. So since childhood, I was having some kind of fascination towards nature, but nothing was serious. It was not serious. I was doing some, rescuing a few reptiles and those kinds of stuff. And in no way I was seriously involved in lower fauna like a butterfly or a dragonfly or a spider. So when I came to Bangalore, I was staying alone here. So in front of my computer lab, there is a small garden. Okay. And I used to observe and those flying jewels and beauties, fluttering around in front of me. Bangalore is, fortunate and very blessed with a lot of butterflies. So I used to see those butterflies. Then I gave it a thought, why can't I photograph a few butterflies? I was not having any camera. I searched into my computer science Elmira and found a small camera there. It was a small point and shoot camera. And I went to the market, purchased four simple torch cells. Can you imagine? I purchased simple torch cells. So I purchased those cells and brought and click a great egg fly sitting on the wall, male. Okay. And I never knew what is that butterfly. So that snap was only one was possible with that particular cell. You cannot click more than one shot with every red cell in a camera, the fifth flash. So then after one shot, it's gone. I cannot click second one. So I was frustrated what has happened. Then I went to internet and searched how to operate a point and shoot camera. Okay. Then I got a point. Okay. I cannot use these batteries. I have to go for those rechargeable cells with better, MHs. Then I went and purchased a pair of cells and rather four cells and started clicking butterflies. So that's how I started clicking butterflies. And after clicking, I was having a laptop, I was processing and keeping photographs to myself. And these are not very good photographs, not very appealing. Okay. So then how to get those identifications? Then I went to Yahoo. I was having a Yahoo ID, and suddenly I searched, there is a group called Butterfly India. It was to my surprise that group existed, and I sent a joint request to the group, and it was accepted, and I started posting a few images there. There were many people, very known experts in that group. Later on, I came to know that Dr. Kalesh is not Kalesh. I used to call him Kalash, K-A-L-A-S-H. I was several times Dr. Kalesh told me, what is this? You are calling me Kalash. I'm not Kalash. Being a monk, Kalash was more, it is coming naturally to me. So, yeah. Okay, I changed it to Kalesh later on. So slowly, I started learning from people like Dr. Kalesh, Balakrishna Velappil, even Dr. Kunte was sometimes, available. And Vijay Varve was there. And there were, Monsoon was there on the group. There was, I think those days, I had some observations identified by none other than this, what is his name? He's the Mysore-based, he's now in the US. What is his name? I'm forgetting him. Das.
Nitin?
Huh? Yeah, talk about Nitin. Das. Nitin was a kid. Nitin was never Nitin never existed that time. His name, I'm forgetting his name. This guy now is in US. He has written a book on Karnataka butterflies also. We'll leave it. Okay. I'm sorry that I'm forgetting his name. So those were my, those people started. Even Gaurav was there. Gaurav Akbekar. I still remember. And my Milind Bakare was there, and I started learning slowly. Then I purchased my first book on butterflies. That was by Krishnamay Kunte's book. That Butterflies of Peninsular India. I ordered through Flipkart and got it. And after that,
Ashok sir, one sec. Sorry to interrupt.
It is long story. Long story.
Hanish sir has commented, listen Das.
Kishan, sorry, Kishan, I'm very sorry, Kishan, yeah, Kishan was there, after that, those books, that first book of Butterflies of Peninsular India helped me, and that book was soon followed by the Bible of Indian Butterflies book, which one? The Isaac Kenker's book of... Yes, that was the Bible of Indian Butterflies. I still remember those days. That book, Butterflies of India book, that book I purchased and started learning. Somewhere in 2009, I had to do a small website project with my students. And it was a collaborative project on the platform of Oracle's ThinkQuest International. It was a website designing platform, that is competition, international competition, that collaborative learning and website designing. And we designed a website. All technical support was given by me. And that website had about 30 plus photographs of butterflies, from mainly from Bangalore, some from Assam, some from Chandigarh and Ambala, that areas. And one collaboration was through Italy also. There were two girls from Italy who were Rome who participated in the collaboration. So we built up a website and we submitted the website for the competition. And we won a special honorable mention award. That honorable mention award included a Apple laptop for each one of us. That means six students and two mentors. Each of us received one laptop each. And... that was the beginning of more involvement for me towards learning butterflies seriously. Now everybody left, all six, six plus one, seven left. They had no interest left after receiving the laptop, but my journey started. I started learning through various websites and archives, and then came the magic was forming of Butterfly India Facebook group, which was formed by Kishan Das, and we all became members, and it was a revolution kind of thing. So many people joined, and so many posts started to pour into that platform. And in somewhere that time, Krishna May came from US, came back to India, and he conducted a meeting at IISc to initiate the actually that very idea of your I Found Butterflies website. So I remember with me, Krishna Meg, there was one guy from Bangalore. I don't even remember who else attended. Ajit Unnikrishnan attended that that particular meet at IISc, and that I Found Butterflies came to existence. So my interest and my hobby became passion, back a passion became an obsession kind of thing. I kept on learning things about butterflies, especially of Western Ghats. Then Dr. Kalesh, you know, and Valakrishna Velappil, those two guys were instrumental in, you know, igniting the, and even Dr. Saji, if you remember, those three people ignited that flare of sort of starting the, you know, that hobby of you know, serious documentation of life cycles of butterflies. I also started doing that, and I learned a lot of things in that journey. Completed almost 150 life cycles. After that, it stopped. I'm not doing much of life cycles these days. I also say that I'll only do life cycles of butterflies for those like butterflies whose life cycle has not been done. It's not that I'm not going to do it, but it will be only for those which have not been done. All common ones, I should not do anymore. There are many people, you know, youngsters who can do it. Now, after that, my serious studies went for butterflies of other parts of our country. And especially my hobby group, my key group was the Tarukas group. If you remember, Tarukas, I wanted to decode. Tarukas, I wanted to decode, and we sat in NCVS with Krishna Meg, and I requested him, why can't we write a paper on Tarukas? Mm-hmm. So it was, you know, it started about 5 years back.
Mm-hmm.
It is not that it's being, you know, it's a idea which was, you know, mooted recently. So Krishna Meg goes, okay, you start. And Paresh got involved into that. Paresh, Abhay Soman, and you know, Milind Bakre, myself, and all the authors, we started starting the early stages of all the Tarukas in our country. We failed in decoding only one of them.
Okay.
That is the Vatasari Dharta from Assam. Tarukas Vatasari Dharta. We failed in that. Rest, all the Tarukas, we did the early stages. Myself did four, and Paresh did a few. Abhay did from Himalayan Venusus and that Hazara. And we wrote, and this guy, our Krishna Meg and Dipendra, they did a huge amount of research work with the archives and various material available on that particular day. And we wrote a paper in that, and it became a kind of monograph which is available for everybody to read. And almost everything is done in that genus. And I wrote another paper with Dr. Ankita Gupta on parasitoids, where we discovered a new species. And things are going on. And then came in 2012 when Nitin, who by then became a very good butterfly professional, almost a scientist, and Nitin Ravikant Achari. So he discovered the lilac flower thing.
At
Bangalore.
So,
following that butterfly.
So he also
went with us.
No, we'll get to that part later. Sir, we missed you. I think he's on another call, so let's wait for him to join again. Left. Oops. Yes, sir. So I'm giving a request to you again. Just give me a minute. I'm unable to search you. Waiting for you to accept my request again.
Hi.
Yes, sir.
Sorry, there was a network issue for a moment. and power came. That's why I switched over to now to our Wi-Fi.
No,
that's how it's all started. Lot of things flew the time flew, and I learned a lot from many friends. And we, what was I was talking about? Lilac Silver Line. I followed
We'll talk about that. We'll talk about that afterwards. So that will come under.
Yeah. Then my story is, it's still a journey. Still a journey.
Yeah.
Journey has not ended.
Yeah. So the next question, just after I heard you talking about Lilac Silver Line and stuff. So tell us about a lot of, you know, education and outreach programs, and also about more about BBC, how it got formed, and etc. Yeah.
I think myself and Rohit, I came to know about Rohit through the Butterfly India group, Yahoo group, and one day we decided to go for a butterfly trip. One day, myself, Rohit. One of my student that time, his name is Karthik, and Karthik Subramaniam, and one lady from Bangalore. I'm forgetting her name. So all four of us boarded into his car and went to Sangam. Sangam is a place about 100 kilometers from. There, because we had a tip off that there are a lot of butterflies there. Unfortunately, we did not see anything. So that is the first day, the first outing way back about seven years almost over. I think 8 years, not seven, 8 years. So we went for a butterfly trip. Then we formed two groups, one on Facebook. That Bangalore Butterfly Club, and one on I think WhatsApp has come. I think WhatsApp group, and it is a very informal group, and we manage people to join us who were interested to do butterfly works in and around Bangalore. That was the there was nothing serious about that. Then it started. People started to join us. You know, we four founder members, myself, Hanish, Nitin, and Rohit Girotra. So we started encouraging people to join us for walks. And Rohit started a very, very serious kind of work with the butterflies of Dorasane Palaya Forest Association in Bangalore. And that serious work continued for six years, every month, going there twice, honestly. Recording, documenting butterflies scientifically as a citizen scientist, you know, half hourly counts for from 9 to 12. And that record he kept in Excel file and maintained the Excel file for 6 years. Now, after years, can you imagine how many records he has from one place? It is about more than 1 lakh records.
Wow, sir.
More than 1 lakh. That much of record he has accumulated, and while he was going for his walks, he invited people to join him. And during that mission of people joining him, BBC started to grow, build up. BBC started to build up, and many people who were fed up from going into birding trips with big cameras, they switched over from birding to. Because they found it not. They were very seasoned birders. They are very seasoned birders. You know, they found it. No, it is not very interesting now. We're not that fascinating to go for birding. It is very good to go into macro, and the challenge is more difficult in butterflying. So they joined us, and BBC was formed. And then the Forest Department saw our interest, and they reached us. Because Dorasane Palaya happens to be a part of the Forest Department Research Center. So the PCCF or additional PCCF that time was Sanjay Mohanji. Now he's PCCF of Karnataka. Sanjay Mohanji reached us, and he initiated for the Butterfly Festival of Bangalore. And it is now 3 years have passed, fourth year we have done Butterfly Festival in Dhurasana Paliya, and people join us, school children join us, we go, we do a lot of activities including walks and some talks and seminars and symposiums are, and competitions are being held that time. And people like, you know, Kartikeyan Srinivasan, Kartikeyan you might be knowing, and our Krishnamai Kunte, and other solvers like Hanish and Nitin, even the Nagraj ji, our senior members of BBC. Nagraj sir, he delivered a lot of what interesting stuff there, including me also. I also delivered a few talks, and people became very curious. So many articles also came into our the local newspapers over the years, and almost every month one article is to come. Now it is Rajapalayam is gaining more popularity, and Coimbatore, I can see those articles. Wonderful things are happening in yourself and other, and I think Mohan Prasad also doing very good work there, and the things have shaped up in India. The citizen science initiative towards butterflies, people having more number of eyes watching camera and taking camera into the wild and finding butterflies. This I found butterflies have become a key to everyone's interest, and they're huge number of contributors are contributing to I found. Now our initiatives on BBC are still going on. Recently, last year we did the first survey in one of the national parks of Karnataka, BBC, and that was because Sanjay Mohanji, now PCCF of Karnataka, he initiated this this survey, and we conducted a survey at the Kali Tiger Reserve, and we had done it very meticulously and submitted a report, and hopefully we'll be doing more number of surveys in the coming months in various sanctuaries of Karnataka.
That was a huge information we got about BBC and the various works you have been doing. So apart from this, I would like to ask you, what do you suggest a new person, be it a school student or college student, who attends Butterfly Festival? What is that one suggestion you give them if they want to take this as a serious hobby, or various amateurs who attend this festival and if they want to conserve butterflies? So what is that one suggestion you give them?
Okay, this is a very interesting question. Very interesting question. What has happened in our system of education? The flaw is we tend to invest much of our time inside the classroom.
In
sitting in the benches and taking notes from teachers and learning from stuff which is not natural. So it is suggested that we should come out of the class, see the environment around, and learn from our environment. So when you go close to the environment, we tend to observe things very, very, very closely. Why I say butterflying is more challenging and more learning oriented than doing anything else. Not only butterflying, I'm talking about macro work, or rather observing the nature very closely. When you go, say I talk about butterflies. Now, when you go near a butterfly, we see a butterfly, you see the color patterns, we see the spots, we see the pattern, the wings, the shape, and all those things we see. Then we see how it is flying. Is it flying fast, or is it flying slow? Where it is sitting, which flower it is nectaring, where it is laying eggs, which are the predators, which are attacking. So our learning curve grows. From butterflies, we go to the nectar plants, we go to the larval host plants, we go to the predators which attack butterflies, we see migration, we see roosting, we see mud puddling, and all those kinds of activities we learn. And since butterflies are bioindicators and they are model organisms for research, if a person takes butterflies as a hobby, first of all, he is happiness. He'll never be angry in life. He will learn how to deal things with patience. First thing I learned from butterflying is patience.
Even me.
Secondly, my anger scale has gone down. I don't get angry. Even people who try to perturb, they try to disturb me, make me angry, I don't get angry. So these things I gained from watching butterflies, firstly. And third, if you have knowledge, then people will definitely connect to you. We have got a very good pool of people virtually. May, you know, not only virtually, if you approach them, it become actual friends. It happened with me many a times. Wherever I go inside in Karnataka or in Himalayas or any place, I get one friend there at least, who is there standing with his bike or car to take me for a wildlife trip. And it is not only with me, it's everybody. This network has grown in such a way that people have become so good friends that people are ready to help each other. You go to Assam, you call Raju Das, he'll be ready with his car. Take him to Rani. You go to Dehradun, you call Rahul Kala or Sanjay Sondhi, they will be ready with their bikes to take you for a butterfly trip. It's happening, even Vivek Sarkar. And now Pranab Gokhale is also there. So it becomes so wonderful network that if you want to reach places where you don't know where to go and how to go, you will get a friend there who will help you out. A lot of benefits, only benefits, no drawbacks. Yeah. That is the beauty of learning benefits.
And a few more questions we wanted to ask you is this more related to just personally to you. What is your favorite butterfly and a fond memory with it?
My favorite butterfly is a very, very difficult question. You know, I had fond memories with many butterflies. So I can tell you stories about butterfly sightings which are first time for me. So I'll give you, okay. I'm not giving you that it is better. It is that butterflies favorite because all butterflies, even lemon pansy is favorite to me. I don't say that they are not favorite to me because they are everywhere around me. They are also good. I observe them also. So I'll tell you a story how butterflying has become so interesting and it's a storytelling affair for me. I was supposed to do a butterfly survey at Munnar, and then it was summer season. I went to Chinnar and reached Chinnar in the morning. I told Dr. Kalesh that, okay, I'll be reaching in the evening itself because from next day the survey starts. I want to stay till evening at Chinnar and do some survey. My target was to find one butterfly there. Only one. Can you tell me which one?
Nilgiridid. Is that right?
Yes, Nilgiridid. Oh. Nilgiridid. Correct. So that was before me, Prashant Bhatt went and did some wonderful photographs of Nilgiridid. So I took one of the watchers and requested him to accompany me. So I went around the area, maybe covered about 8 to 10 kilometers, in that forest. I could not find a single Nilgiridid. Not a single one. So we were disappointed, and that watcher said, okay, it's now 1 o'clock, we should return back. So since morning 9 o'clock till 1 o'clock, I was walking and trying to search for Nilgiridid. So we sat down by the stream, dejected, looking at some other butterflies. Okay, I was not interested to take the click those. Okay, it's with me. So suddenly one butterfly came and sat on my shoulder, right shoulder.
I could see it.
That was a Nilgiridid, It came and sat on my, it was Nilgiridid, male Nilgiridid was sitting on my shoulder. I was not able to take the photograph. I was unable to see, how can I take a photograph of a butterfly which is sitting on my shoulder? I prayed to God Almighty, please let me take a snap of it. My prayers were heard. I could take that butterfly on my left finger. On my forefinger, I took it from my shoulder. It came happily set on my forefinger. And I photographed it. And that is how I got my Nilgiridid. These are things which makes you happy and make you contented with, okay, I went there, I got it. I got it.
Yeah, even such memories stay close to your heart for so many years together. And few more last set of questions which I would like to ask you is, which is that one place in India you would love to visit, or it's a dream place for you to visit, but it's still pending, and why is that?
To be frank, I have not visited Northeast yet. All those places in Northeast, may it be Rani, may it be South Garo Hills, may it be Namdafa, may it be Zero or Pakke or whatever you say, all those names are till now French and Latin to me. I want to visit all those areas and I want to stay there for some time, do some serious butterfly work and come back. Baksa, my God, I have not visited Baksa yet. My friends have gone. I was just sort of cursing myself because that season when they go, na, that is my CBSE evaluation season. I cannot leave Bangalore that duration, March and April. Those 2 months I cannot leave. So I hope to visit that those areas. I tell you, not only Northeast, Western Himalayas also gives you a lot of scope to observe butterflies. And in fact, I was fortunate to visit for 1 day in Dehradun, a place called Minog Wildlife Sanctuary, for 1 day. And okay. In 1 day, I got 55 species. All were new to me. All were first timer for me. For 2 hours with Rahul Kala, I was there. For 2 hours, in 2 hours, we got 55 species. All were new to me. I never saw. I know all of them. I can identify them by seeing them. But I have not seen them in my life. That included, you know, those pale green sailors and orange staff sergeants. And you know, spangles and whatnot, you name them, they were there. So shortly, maybe 1 or 2 days, I'm going to put my blog up with this particular post with so many photographs that I'm, you know, how to post all those photographs, I don't know. So yeah, there are so many, about 100 plus photographs I will upload there, and you'll be able to see that blog. I'll post it on Facebook and my journey to Minog Wildlife Sanctuary. So you can also go to Western Himalayas. It's not that it's not having butterflies. Wonderful butter stuff is there.
Sure. That was very nice to hear. So the last question. So we have come to the end of the session. So the last question which I wanted to ask you is, tell us about Bangalore butterflies, the status of butterflies in Bangalore. Currently, how many species are there? And anything and everything.
Bangalore, since we have been documenting butterflies, you know, before me, I tell you, Karthikeyan published a checklist of butterflies in Bangalore. Karthikeyan Srinivasan. This is way back, somewhere in 2005 or 6. I don't know the year. It was published. That checklist, we have added up butterflies in that. Now, at present, Bangalore has got 170 plus species of butterflies. Wow. 171, I think, to be precise, I'm not sure. 171 species of butterflies are there. We have rediscovered a few butterflies. We have added a few butterflies to Bangalore checklist. Okay. No, rediscovery includes indigo flash and a few more. I'm not remembering those names at this point of time. But we have discovered lilac silver line. We have added white-tipped lime blue. We have added anomalous nawab. Those butterflies we have added to Bangalore. In common lashkar, we say, and plain hedge blue. There are quite a few species we have added up in Bangalore. And, you know, Bangalore, 170 species, this migration species also, migratory species also come in Bangalore. Includes, red heron also being spotted in Bangalore. Not very common, but it has been spotted, of course, in somewhere in, and recently, you know, what was spotted by Nagraji in Bangalore? Recent.
I didn't see, sir. I don't remember.
Oh, Nagraji spotted a red admiral at Dorasanapalia.
Oh, okay. I didn't see.
Red admiral. Photographed by Nagraji. And that was very surprising. And red admiral in Dorasanapalia is the last edition, if you call it an addition, to Bangalore checklist.
Okay. So we have come to the end of question and answer session. So we'll view if any of the viewers have sent you any questions. So people who are watching, if you have any questions on Bangalore butterflies or anything for that matter for Ashok sir, please do send in the comments. We'll be online for a couple of minutes until we have our next speaker. So Paresh sir has asked you when to plan our next expedition to find missing white-edged blue baron.
There is no white-edged blue baron in Western Ghats. It is blue baron. There is no white-edged blue baron in Western Ghats. Paresh, you are wrong. First time you are wrong. You are always correct, but first time you are wrong. It is blue baron. There are two different species, distinct species. White-edged blue baron and blue baron are two distinct species. There are reports of blue baron from a specimen has been collected from Sambhaji Ghat and Karnataka. Blue baron is there. And I'll tell you one secret story. You may soon hear from us about blue baron.
We are eagerly waiting.
Yeah. You may hear from us about me.
And any more questions? Anybody?
Paresh wanted to test me. He is joking.
Yeah.
Paresh wanted to test me whether I am right or he is right.
He says, yes, we need to plan.
Paresh, it has been done. wait for paper. Not me.
Yeah. So I can get a clue from this. So this particular person, he had, you know, when we had this conversation last week, he said, 2 to 3 species have been, you know, included in Western Ghats. So if that is this, then yeah, eagerly waiting.
Can you talk about migration and how amateurs should be observing? So wonderful, a good question has come from Idea Malavarika. So wonderful question has come from Idea Malavarika. I don't know who is this gentleman. I know Idea Malavarika. Kishan, he was Idea Malavarika.
We only know Idea Malavarika. We don't know who the person is.
Okay, wonderful question. See, migration in India has not been studied extensively and properly. We have recently formed a WhatsApp group and especially studying the migratory pattern of Western Ghat butterflies. That includes the migration of mainly of the Danaines, those blue tigers and crows, which migrate from Eastern Ghats to Western Ghats and Western Ghats to Eastern Ghats, and forward and reverse and forward migrations. Now it's forward migration is going on, and the path of migration, and including this migration, we have some other migrations also. There is altitude migration of albatross. There is a migration of emigrants, which take place in huge number, and there are migration of lime butterflies, lime swallowtails, and even painted ladies do migrate. Everybody knows that. Even pea blues migrate. Mostly butterflies, you know, 90% species of butterflies are migratory in nature. Some of them are local migratory migrants and some are distant migrants. Of course, it is to be, we need to do an extensive study, and citizen scientists can, or citizens can take part in, you know, migration. So they need to learn 2-3 things. First thing is to start documenting and spot records of migratory species, where they have seen. And if you have the capacity of, you know, catching, it is, I don't suggest it to everybody, because catching a butterfly is not actually suggested for everybody. But somebody, if get a permission and can catch a few butterflies and mark them and release them. Marking, you have to learn how to mark butterflies. There are inks available to mark them. And you can write a code in the butterfly, that which date, and those coding have to, there has to be unified coding system, so that we can find out wing marking. We cannot mark small butterflies. We can mark the, because their wings are very sturdy, those Danaines, blue tigers and crows. At least we can do that. And if we can, you know, recheck those, because we need a huge team for migration study. It is not that 10 people or 20 people can do it. At least 200 people are required to do a migration study of butterflies across the state of Karnataka, Kerala and Andhra Pradesh and Tamil Nadu. At least 200. So we need to have a team of 200 people dedicated towards study of butterflies of during migration every season. And it should be done for not 1 year, for about 5 to 6 years to come to a conclusion. What is happening?
So I guess we don't have any more questions. So as we are running late for the next speaker, Ashok sir, thank you. Thank you so much for accepting.
Thank you, Sharan, for giving me the chance. See you soon. Friends, I will be here. I'm not leaving you guys. I'll be watching the next speaker. Okay. Thank you.
Sure, sir. Thank you so much for joining. So thank you for accepting.
Yeah.